All right, guys, Microsoft Flight Sim 2024 is launching here November 19th in just a few weeks. And the real question is, should you upgrade your computer right now or should you wait? And we're going to go over some specs, some requirements, some hardware, and I'll give you my opinion on what you should do. So let's get into it. Here we go. Now, if it's our first time meeting here, welcome to the channel. My name is Jose. I'm an air traffic controller. I do VR flight sim content. I fly over here in my rig using the Pyrex Crystal Light, Quest 3, Reverb G2 until recently because Microsoft has nixed that. So super sad about that. But anyways, guys, I love everything VR flight sim related, and occasionally I'll show real aviation stuff on here as well. So welcome to the channel. Thank you for joining me. And as we continue, we're going to talk about some of the performance improvements that we've had. And my list here, we have quicker load times, right? Number one, I got to use Microsoft Flight Sim at the World Preview event and use also the Tech Alpha, and you're gonna notice quicker load times. The sim loads significantly faster, and that's also due to the fact that we have thinner clients on your computer, meaning your downloads are gonna be significantly smaller. There's gonna be a lot more cloud gaming being done, which is really interesting. And what does that mean for your internet? You're gonna need better internet for some of you, and a lot of you are gonna be okay, but this is something to know, and we're gonna go over the specs here in just a second. Now, the quick answer is no, you don't upgrade, don't do anything yet. Again, I'm kind of cheating you into the answer here directly. So one of the benefits we're going to get is a revamped engine, right? I don't know all the secrets. I don't know all the code that they've written into this, but we're getting improved performance overall, smoother gameplay, big picture stuff. I mean, I'm telling you guys, but we're definitely getting improved memory management, right? It's going to be a smoother gameplay, RTX shadows in the cockpit. I had said RTX lighting, which is not everywhere, although the lighting has been improved significantly. Look, I don't care. I don't care if there's not RTX everywhere. The lighting here looks infinitely better. The clouds, the way that they interact with each other, it's really good. And I think you guys have seen that and are going to continue to see that. So that's pretty awesome. Now we're going to go over here into the hardware requirements, and I'll bring that up on the screen here. So I kind of wish they had a VR spec over here somewhere, but let's just say VR spec should be the ideal spec and above. Could you get away VR with the ideal spec? Yes. With the recommended spec? No. Absolutely not. VR would not work with the minimum spec. It would not work with the recommended spec. It would work maybe okay with the ideal spec, depending on the headset, depending on your resolution. So that's my quick recap on this. But what you see here, 14700K RTX 4080. I would even recommend a 4070 Ti and above for VR. And then let's talk about the RAM real fast. Do you need 64 gigs of RAM? So Seb had said in an interview that you do not need to upgrade to 64 if all you're doing is simming. Now you might find out that the sim is capable of using 32 gigs of RAM. So right now when I run DCS, same thing, I'm capped out. DCS will use all 32 gigs of RAM. So if I try to record content or do anything else, it's just not ideal to run your computer maxed out with no extra RAM. So if you are a DCS simmer, 64 gigs is a great idea. If you like to create content or are considering it, 64 gigs would be a good idea as well. It's not a requirement that Microsoft Flight Sim is going to use a 64 gigs within itself. Now, Seb had told me in the interview that I did with him in Arizona that they have multiple computers. He had multiple computers running different internet, and overall, it ran really well. So you would probably be okay with 50 megabytes per second. Now, are you going to want more? Yes, I think you're going to want more, you know, at least 50. I recommend 50 as a minimum. I know that that might be attainable for some of you guys, but it might be also difficult. But 50 would be the minimum. Like if you guys are rocking Starlink, I think Starlink and other things like that can pull 100, maybe 120. So just keep that in mind. You're going to want quicker internet. You don't want to be on 10 megabytes a second, even though they say minimum spec. I would stay away from that. There's a lot of data being loaded here. So one of the reasons we're getting this performance boost, which everyone's going to see, and this is why I tell you don't upgrade yet, hang tight, is that we're going to get multi-threaded support, and that's going to be on your CPUs, whether it's Intel or AMD. A lot of these modern CPUs have, I don't know, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 24 CPU cores that are able to distribute the workload. Now, I don't know how efficiently it's going to be doing it. I don't know, you know, to what level we're going to be getting very specific performance boost. But the point is that it's going to be a gain and it's going to be really good. I know some people are kind of nitpicking and saying this and this and that. It's only using three. Look, the point is multi-threaded support is happening. We're getting it. I saw the improvement. A lot of people already shared it. And same thing in DCS. When DCS went to multi-threaded CPUs support, it was just a huge improvement for all of us, especially those in VRPs. We need every last ounce of performance for virtual reality. So we're going to have better performance there. We're going to have better lighting, better visuals, the overall world, it looks better. It's going to be significantly better as far as the terrain, and the mesh data has been improved, so we can definitely expect that. And let's talk about a couple of tips here that I have for you guys. All right, so let me recap my three top tips here for you guys. Number one, wait and see. Just wait for the launch, test it yourself, see what other people report. Let's see if you have 32 gigs of RAM and somebody has a similar build and they post it with 64 gigs of RAM. You can wait and see. Maybe you find somebody that has your same exact setup, but then they upgraded the GPU. That's a great comparison for you. That way you know, okay, cool, that's what I'm going to expect to get. Also, if you guys are in my Discord or in my Facebook group, you guys can chat with each other. Everyone's going to be dumping all their performance, how it is. I'm going to be doing the same. And that's the best thing I recommend. Wait to see what other people are doing, how their performance is, and then you can decide from there. Now, number two is Black Friday sales, right? We got Black Friday sales. We got the holiday. This is going to be excellent time for you to upgrade. But as you kind of watch and wait for everyone to upgrade, you can kind of start shopping around, putting things in your cart, looking to see what's the next piece of hardware that you want to get, but get a deal on it. Don't pay full price. So finally, when it comes to the GPU, you know, we know that NVIDIA is going to be releasing the 5000 series here coming soon. And I really don't think that people should be upgraded into 4090s or 4080s or 4080 Supers just yet, even if your goal isn't to buy a 5000 series GPU. So as soon as the 5000 series GPUs get announced, there's going to be a lot of people fire selling their used hardware. Now, I know used hardware is not for everyone. I've bought plenty of used hardware when it comes to certain tech items just because I know what I'm shopping for, even GPUs, and they work just fine. And the other thing is to consider, guys, there's no mining craze right now. So people aren't sitting here mining Bitcoins, abusing GPUs. It's just not a thing that it was years ago during COVID. So we're going to be in a place now that you should be able to pick up a used GPU comfortably, you know, from a rated seller and know that you're getting a good deal because they want the cash to upgrade to a 5000 series GPU. So consider that and get ready for that. Now, if you want to sell your GPU and you're okay being without a GPU, consider the fact that like the moment the 5000 series drops, you're not going to be able to ask for what you can ask for today for your current hardware. So if you do want to sell it to upgrade, do it now. Don't wait. You might be without a GPU for a little bit of time, but you're going to have more cash in your pocket. So just something to consider. I've seen this happen three times already. And the other thing is I'm not going to leave out is AMD, because I know my boy Sven out there repping AMD. They offer great value for performance, for power usage, as opposed to Intel. You know, these things are just 14900K. Some hot stuff, man. Pulling a lot of power. All sorts of issues. Now, I'm on the 12900K, and I don't think that there's a real big reason for me to upgrade just because I saw some of those issues, and the performance I'm getting is pretty good. So I'll definitely be waiting for things to get ironed out, which I think most of them have been. But again, do not forget about AMD out there. They produce some great hardware at a great price. So should you upgrade your computer today? And the answer is no, straight up. I recommend you guys wait. Just take it easy because, look, a lot of us are going to get the sim. We're going to show our performance. You're going to see other people show comparisons 2024 to 2020. They're going to show hardware reviews. And at that point, I think you're going to be in a much better place to really decide whether or not you should upgrade your computer and what you should upgrade. And not only that, you're going to be able to try it. So it might be a little bit iffy running two sims at the same time on your computer. Some of us have had some issues, but that's the least of your worries if you're going to upgrade. Now, if you are of the idea that you don't want to be a Microsoft Setting Simulator tester, then by all means, hang tight, don't do it. Some people say, you know, it's not worth it. Look, I'm not here to convince you to get the game. If you think it's a great game, sim, whatever you call it, do it. Just, I would say, wait on the hardware. Don't upgrade just yet. So personally, I am going to keep my eye for the RTX 5090 GPU, but I'm not getting rid of my 4090. I did sell the 3090 eventually to upgrade, but it's one of those things that this is a beast, and I'd like to maybe keep this as an editing PC and then eventually just get a separate PC just for flight simulation. So I think that's going to be the way that I take this route. Now, another thing to say, guys, VR is absolutely epic, and the Pimax Crystal Light is what I've been using. In fact, I'll have a video on this soon because this will be the official headset by Microsoft supported for Microsoft Flight Sim 2024. So that is pretty cool. And if you guys want to know how I see in VR, or how to learn how to see your headset or your equipment in VR, not the headset, check out this video right here. And you can definitely learn how I show you how to see your hardware in VR. Take it easy, guys. Peace out.